See, this is the one problem with classical music.
He has the better
continue. hear the loudest thing on the program.
Thank you. Domine, Magda is reminiscing to some friends at a party. She is remembering a magical night years ago when she met a young man. They had an instant connection and she could see new worlds opening before her. But there was a song singing a warning. Young girl, defend your heart against kisses and smiles. You will pay for them with tears. So she left and never saw him again.
Oh, entails moving furniture here, I wanted to tell you a little bit about what you're about to hear. I'm deeply grateful for Kimberly Bryant and Mildred Roche. They're doing the premiere tonight of the song and the musical that John Jeter and I are writing together about heaven. And this is actually the last big number. We don't have the full band here. We just have the piano accompaniment. I got the idea to write this musical while sitting in this recital hall listening to Kimberly give a master class with one of our voice students. And she was asking the student, you know, what is this singer talking about in this show? And she said about meeting somebody in heaven. And I said, So I started writing notes all over my program. And a few years later, here we are. The John, by the way, is a professional writer, and he's published fiction and nonfiction, so he's a very successful writer, and I dragged him into the project to write the story, the book as they call it, the dialogue, and also a lot of the lyrics. And Kimberly is going to come out here. She's appearing in the role of God, except in the show she's not called that. She has the name Eternal Great Generative Spirit, in other words, eggs. So she's going to be singing her big song at the end, and so I guess you can sort of think of it as an eggs benediction.
Afterwards, please see these two. I still have questions. which stands for blunt force trauma. Step outside. This is not a piece of music for you, because I'm going to pummel you.
a movie that had sound. And so you would look at a movie screen, and every now and then you'd see captions where you would see what the actors were trying to say. And silent films would be accompanied either by some kind of a small string group with a few winds thrown in, or they would be accompanied by, wait for it, an organ. Yes, yes, yes. And the organ could do all kinds of things by himself, and it was cheaper to use organists. So what I want you to do when you listen to this music is think of a 1920 silent film. Imagine some lady being tied to the railroad tracks and being rescued by somebody. That's pretty much what you're about to hear. And the guy that wrote this piece was an organist, and he probably played in a few theaters in his lifetime. So enjoy the Rhapsody by Clifford Demarest.
Thank you. 1995 Pixar movie, Toy Story, introduced a world where toys and stuffed animals come to life when humans aren't around. This is my stuffed animal, Wimpy. And I've had him longer than I can remember. He's probably at least 62, maybe 65 years old. And he wants to share some thoughts with you tonight. And I'm glad I kept him because given the revelations in the movie Toy Story, it would have been a terrible thing to get rid of him. Anyway, he's going to share some stories, some thoughts with you tonight. I'm going to put him right here. And I'm going to walk around the other side of the piano and just listen. He's insisted on using the pronouns he and him. I hope that doesn't bother you.
Thank you. Thank you.